Assalamu alaikum. Today I will talk about some of the important and fundamental principles that always impact your decisions, not only relating to your career but to your life as well. These are the principles which are an important and integral part of your life. It is an important part of your charter of values that you carry through and through, and those values you not only exercise and apply to your decisions, but these are going to be passed on to the future generations as well. So number one is the decision to go for a next career move. So how to prepare for the next career move? Because you have a current role and maybe you are going to go for the next move, and then you have a target, you have a goal that you have kept for yourself, that okay, at certain time I am going to go up to this level in my career. Because when you are moving from one level to the other level in your career, there is always a need to upgrade your skill level, your competency level, because there is always a skill gap between one role and the role that you are going to do in the future. As far as the employers are concerned, they are always wanting you to get things done as per their own needs. So then you have to have an assessment of your current level of skills and the required skills for the next role. If there is any gap, that is supposed to be filled, because it is how you will be competent enough to play your next role very effectively. So this is to be done not only through on the job training, but through reading, maybe through online learning, maybe through talking to your mentors and your seniors. So this is an important principle which we need to keep in our mind when we are going to go for any career move, and this will give us an edge for our vertical and horizontal growth. Principle number two, when you go for any senior role in any organization, you need to know two to three important things. First, you should know who is your manager. Try to get some information that who is going to be your manager and your supervisor with whom you will work very closely, so that you could be able to prepare yourself and align your own thoughts and your intellectual connection with that particular person, because he or she is going to be your supervisor. Next is that you should know your team, you should know your close peers, because if you want that you should be landing into your new role comfortably and you don't find too many surprises in your new role, in your new organization, so you try to get information about your close peers and about your team also, so that you are mentally prepared that these are the people with whom you will work very closely, and it is how you can manage your work with them, and it is how you can align your behaviors, your attitudes, and your own values with these people. Principle number three is that how to really take care of your intellect, how to take care of your mental makeup, how to take care of your basic values, which are always there in your life. What are those values? For example, everybody has some of the values which are very much part of their life, and these values are going to impact your decisions, these values are going to impact your relationships, and these values are going to impact your journey of your career, journey of your life. For example, some of the fundamental values, universal values that I will talk about and that I try to exercise in my life and with my family also, it's simplicity, honesty, integrity, it is compassion, it is being positive. So these are some of the values, or any other values that you have in your mind. So you should keep in your mind, and you should try to really make them a part of your journey, because these are some of the values which are non-negotiable. Because you certainly most of the time don't negotiate on these values. Any compromise on these values means that you are going to be not a real person who you are. There is no need to be stubborn, there is need to be flexible, but I think some of the basic principles we should uphold and we should keep close to our heart in our journey of life, in our journey of career. The fourth principle is the compassionate leadership, because leadership, you will be in any role in your current organization and your future organization. You have a leadership in your family also. So you will be assessed, you will be seen by your organization, by your team, by your seniors. How you are going to behave with your family, how you are going to treat them, how you are going to take care of them. So I strongly recommend, and I try to do it myself also, that we should be compassionate to our families first and foremost. And then we should try to have a compassion for our teams also. We should have a compassion for our peers. We should have a compassion for the people with whom we will work very closely. So these are the important principles, and the last one is really, really very important, and that is that how you are going to look back into the future when you make any decisions. For example, there are certain situations in which you are not really ready, or you are a bit reluctant to make any decision, but then you have to look back that in case you don't make this decision today, and it is going to have a long lasting, long term impact on your future generations, on your children, on your grandchildren. So then you need to really figure out that which one is really important and which one is really well calculated and which one somehow is riskier, but it is good to take that decision so that tomorrow morning you will be able to tell your future generation, your children and your grandchildren, that this is what you had done, something extraordinary, and it has created a long-term, long-lasting positive impact on the lives of your children and on the lives of your grandchildren. So these are some of the fundamental principles I wanted to talk about today, because when you are on the road to your life, you are doing two things simultaneously. One is the career growth, whether you are a professional, you are an entrepreneur, you are a businessman, and the other is your family growth. So both go side by side. So you need to create a balance. And these five fundamental principles are equally applicable to your life, to your family, and to your career. So I hope that these ideas will benefit you and all of my respected viewers in one way or the other. And if you have any questions about these fundamental principles, or if you need any advice on the career movement that you intend to take in future, you make comments in my videos, you can contact me as well, and I will try to really advise and I will try to really suggest something which is workable in any given situation. May Allah Almighty bless you all with a great success. We will meet again in some more topic discussions through my future videos. Allah Hafiz.